Halcyon News. Your mandated duty as a good citizen.
Hotter than usual in here. Hope we're not catching Junlei on a bad day.
Probably aren't.
All day in here and not have looked at half the best stuff. It's all pretty worn, though.
Hello?
Junlei Tennyson. I'm captain around here, but chief to my friends. Hope you don't mind the formal introduction. Groundbreaker doesn't see many visitors.
Alicia Clark. Nice place you got here, chief.
No, it isn't. It's a mess. But it's my mess, so I'll take the compliment.
Okay.
Just so we understand each other, I'm the final word on the ship. The Mardits, the crew, the engineers, their family. I hope there won't be any problems while you're visiting.
Copy that, chief.
At ease. Nice to see an outsider with some working brain cells.
Thanks.
So what brings you to Groundbreaker? I'm curious, even though 9 times out of 10, the answer's just passing through.
Now that my ship's out of impound, I can safely say I'm headed for Monarch.
Interesting. The powers that be paint an ugly picture of Monarch. Critters and such. Maybe someone in the promenade can get you the right weapon for the job. We see a lot of the same faces coming and going. Most of them board spies and corporate sprats. Makes it hard to trust outsiders. You seem different, so welcome aboard.
Thanks.
Dr. Fenhill, I hope you've reconsidered my offer to stay on full time. My crew are never short on dents and bruises.
I'm trying to live a more balanced life. Gun in one hand, scalpel in the other.
I already knew it'd be easier to teach an automatic heart surgery than to change your mind. Fair travels, Ellie.
You two know each other.
Groundbreaker's a small town in a big ship, and anyone who spends any time here gets to know Junlei.
We don't see a lot of competent surgeons on Groundbreaker. Dr. Fenhill is my on-again-off-again freelancer. I take it she'll be joining your crew full-time?
I don't like to put a label on things. Let's keep it casual.
If you ever decide to settle down, there's a home for you on Groundbreaker.
I heard you're having a heat problem. What's going on?
Groundbreaker's radiators need replacement parts. They're dumping superheated air into my ship.
I'm sure your capable staff can stay ahead of the problem.
My engineers have managed to keep the heat to livable levels, but all the fixes are temporary. This wound is bound to fester. Only the board has access to new parts, and I won't let them swindle me into a corner.
Is there no room for compromise?
None. Every time I give in to the board, Groundbreaker loses its freedom. Soon there won't be anything left. I can't allow that. The board isn't helping, and my resources are spread thin. If I don't get those radiators back online, Groundbreaker, everyone aboard, will be cooked alive.
You need a contractor to work this out. I'm available for a reasonable rate.
Reasonable, huh? That's the best news I've heard all day. According to my grandmother's old schematics, the parts we need should be in the back bays.
The back bays. Am I supposed to know where that is?
Sorry, I forget not everyone knows this ship like I do. The back bays are on a lower deck, long abandoned and a haven for miscreants now.
Have you tried sending anyone else down there to get the parts?
I have. One of my engineers, plus a small security detail. They didn't come back. I can't afford to lose any Mardits on this job. No offense, but a freelancer like you is more dispensable.
None taken.
Nice and pragmatic. Thanks for understanding.
Couldn't we try to talk this out with whoever is down there?
Those idiots are immune to reason. And they don't much care if the station melts to pieces. They're content to die last. If you could find some way to solve this without violence, I'd prefer that. But more than anything, we need those parts.
You can't get these parts from anywhere else?
You must not have been here long. In Halcyon, new parts come by way of interstellar freighters from Earth, and the board monopolizes that kind of trade.
Of course they do.
That means I'd have to negotiate with the board. I've already given them the shops, the docking fees, and a damn embassy.
Their negotiations sound like a bureaucratic coup.
Damn right. And while I'm captain of the Groundbreaker, it falls to me to preserve this ship's independence.
I'll get you those parts from the back bays.
Good. Once you've obtained the parts, we can proceed to the next phase of repairs.
I wasn't done talking.
Sorry about the heat. Here, drink up.
Oh.
No excuse for dehydration on my watch.
Thanks. What's it like being a command around here?
Frustrating. Everything down to the circuit boards is past warranty, so I have the pleasure of making life or death decisions on a shoestring budget. Plus, there's no time to train my successor or document fixes in a way that anyone outside the family would understand.
This ship is a family business?
Sure is. The Tennysons came over on the Groundbreaker. My grandmother, Chief Gaying, kept it together during the crossing and until she died. I was promoted only recently, when my mom died. Then I took the leap from Chief Engineer to Captain.
They must have been amazing people to have taught you all you know, I mean, which is a lot.
That means a lot coming from a fellow engineer.
Was a big change, that transition to command?
It was different knowing that I couldn't turn to anyone who could answer the tough questions for me. Maybe you can see why I'm protective of Groundbreaker. This ship is family. It's got tinkerings and bypasses that only Tennysons know about.
Weren't you a little young to be training a successor?
You see any bite-sized Tennyson children running around? I didn't think so. The next captain won't have my heritage. I'll have to foster that talent from somewhere. It's only a question of when.
I'm not gonna ask her where the self-destruct button is. I have some other questions.
You've got my attention.
You don't have a lot of faith in the board. Well, of course you don't.
You're right. I don't. The board is after two things, bits and power. And they only get it by sticking their nose where it doesn't belong.
How do you keep the board at a safe distance?
I placate them when I have something to offer, but I can also be a real hard ass. It'd be a joy if I could kick out the corporate merchants and reclaim the docking fees in my lifetime. Too much of Groundbreaker's income is flowing in the wrong direction. I'd like to see that change.
You must not like Udon Bedford very much.
I like to think of myself as a nice person, but if that gaudy embassy of his was on fire, I might hold my breath a moment before activating the sprinkler system. The board wants control over Groundbreaker. And leeches like Udon Bedford will do anything to please their corporate masters. You've got my attention.
Parvati, you wanted to talk to Junlei? Go ahead.
What? I didn't think you just...
Parvati, is it? That's a lovely name. What can I do for you?
I was just thinking. I haven't got much experience working with actual, real spaceships, Miss Junlei. Chief Junlei.
Junlei is fine.
Well, she's not gonna be leaving me, are you? Gonna say nothing?
Okay. Since you run a whole space station, I was wondering if... Well, maybe you could teach me some things. I could message you later, maybe?
I'd be happy to make the time, Parvati. You can ask me anything.
Yeah, I don't want her to leave. I'm not sure to continue, though.
Wow, great! I'll do that, then. Messages. Later. Oh, your name's pretty, too. I should have said... Sorry. I like it. Honest. Sorry.
Nice job, Parvati.
Couldn't have done it without your moral support, Captain.
Now, if there's nothing else, there are other parts of the ship begging for my attention.
We'll be on our way. I'm not sure if this is going to end up with Parvati leaving for a time, which I do not want. The modern steel wrench in you. Or if she's just going to teach her things and help her become a better engineer, which will only help me in the end. She's not going to see me. Her back's turned, right? modern steel wrench in you. Broaden your horizons with a little light reading. This might look nice in one of the crew's rooms on the unreliable. Like Parvati's room. To convince her even more that she has a home on my ship, not this one. Can I look at this? Is this another story?
Tossball finals are scheduled to air soon, but a scandal has rocked the league and thrown this pivotal game into question.
I've heard this.
Both teams have tested negative for performance enhancing steroids.
I think I've heard that.
A tossball first.
I suppose I could use your terminal for a moment. Jay Tennyson, personal terminal for Groundbreaker Captain. Daily checklist. Radiator temp, plumbing overflow, life support, crew morale, scheduled landings, checklist maintenance, brush teeth. You can do this, Junlei. Personal files. Back bays. More complaints about the state of the bay. I already told the Mardets they're free to flush out McRed and his outlaws. They're so knotted up, seeking warrants and paper justifications, that they want someone else to solve all their problems off the record. Sorry, boys. Not my job. Promenade status. Morale has dipped 18% since Martin Callahan showed up. It's that damn mask. Found another listening device in my office. Thing was the size of a toss ball, with the cord leading all the way back to sublight. Subtle as always, Lilia. Could have sworn the automechanical chef arrived with a company tech. No record of the guy leaving the station. We'll have to look into it. I could give you the answer on that one. Sprat infestation at the Rest and Go is getting out of hand. Ethel better not be ranching those critters again. I swear by law I'll airlock her stall. Messages. From you, Bedford. Udon Bedford. Subject, my dear lady. The implications of your accusations cause my breath to hitch in my throat. I am certain that we can arrive at an agreeable understanding, for what is a board liaison if not a facilitator of handshakes between great powers? Much like the board and yourself? When you do decide to return to the negotiations table, consider once again the embassy expansion plans I laid out. Gestures of good faith do not go unpaid. Udon Bedford, certified liaison. 2. Udon Bedford, subject, obstructionist. So this is from Tennyson to Bedford. The board rejected my request for new radiator parts. Again, even after I greased their wheels with some targeted donations. Funny thing, when I used my admin privileges to survey the outgoing comms, I noticed some activity from your office. You chose your words carefully, but I plucked a juicy phrase from the transcript. Let the frog boil a while longer. And now I have no radiator parts. You're playing with our lives. Did they install you on my ship just to get under my skin? Or are you pulling this shit for fun? JT. Oh, thanks. I'll be going now.
This is Halcyon News. We interrupt your regularly scheduled
back bays. How do I get to the back bays? Well, we can't afford this. Maybe if we do this job, investigating distress signal on Terra 2, right?
Remember Auntie Cleo? Because she remembered.
Is that where my ship is? Oh. Well, apparently we go over here. For that. Get new parts for the radiators. See if I can find this.
When you were
So I don't have an objective marker for that. Gotta find the back base somehow. Acquire the science weapon. Look in Gladys' shop for old records.
Who took your temperature? When you were hungry, who gave... ...give you a new... ...little full of love. Andy Cleo, that's who.
Still betting on the toss ball series? I know you were trying to stop.
CNP pancake mix. Now requires no mixing. Seriously, don't mix it.
Alright, so now I remember who Gladys is. Looking in Gladys' shop for old records. So wait, this is her shop? No, this is the bathroom. So then what's this way? The ship? Oh, it's telling me to go to the ship here.
Lock your whole family tonight.
Great law, is it hot in here? Or is it just my glands acting up again?
I want to talk about that opportunity you mentioned.
Yes, dearie?
What do you want me to do again?
Take that darling ship of yours down to Roseway, where that distress signal I told you about came from. And ferret out some tasty corporate secrets for old Gladys. Shouldn't be too tough for a lass like you, I'd think. Anytime, sweetheart. You know where to find me.
Distress signal. View the distress signal recording on your ship. Okay. Hunt down and kill Captain McRed. Well, this might show me where. No. You cannot travel on near hostiles. So is he back here? Wait. I am near hostiles.
This is Halcyon News. We interrupt your regularly scheduled.
Am I missing something? Oh, back here. Haven't I been back here?
Miss Ellie, Dr. Finhill. I notice your pistol's been making a funny noise.
What are you talking about? I oil it every night.
Well, look here. Your slide's not recoiling fully. You might be due for a new spring. I could take a look, maybe fix it for you.
Sure. I'm short on bits at the moment, but I'll pay you back.
Oh, no. I mean, it don't cost nothing. I got a spare spring in my pocket here, even.
Everything's got a price.
She either likes owing people, or she hates owing people, or both. McRed is that way. Is he down there?
CNP Boston Big Bean. When you need to eat and run, Boston Big Bean is the only one.
He's down. How do I get down there? Oh, wait. Oh. I did not realize I could just walk here, so this must be the way to him. Okay. Okay. We were here briefly. If I kept an Irion on Scylla. Thanks to your introduction, Parvati and Junlei hit it off. Check in with Parvati on the ship to see how things are progressing between the two of them. Well, this is where that's going, exactly. The empty man. Locate a security terminal. Oh. Vicar Max wants to track down the scholar who told him about the banned journal of Mbakonu in order to translate its writing. If the scholar has been through the groundbreaker recently, Max thinks he can track him down by accessing a data cartridge from a terminal in the groundbreaker security office. Right. That sounds like a thing to do. Speak with Lilia Hegan. Once you can access Stellar Bay, return to speak with... Okay. Okay, this, I guess, is unknown where this terminal is. Vendor, vending machine. Doesn't tell us, does it, where terminals are? Point of interest. Let me just see something. Terminal. Okay. Okay, it does, actually. So it's not one of these two. It's all the way back here. Oh, in the security office. Oh. That's why we went in to get back there.
How goes the hunt? I've been ruminating on it, and I decided, if you ain't killed McRed yet, I want you to hurt him a little before you do. Nothing excessive, mind you, but the scoundrel deserves a light beating at least before he kicks off.
I want to talk to you about something else.
Have at it, then.
Okay, not... Well, this guy...
What can Groundbreaker Security do for you today?
I'd really like to get back there.
Yeah, I'm getting that, but this area's off limits, I told you. Maybe if you clear an open bounty and get in good with Commandant Sunita, or help Chief Tennyson fix this heat, that might warrant a thank you tour or something.
Guess I've really gotten good at persuade. We're friends, right, Lee? Do me a favor and all you want.
All right, I guess. In and out, though. Just try not to do any shady stuff. I'd like to keep my job.
Shady stuff. Got it. Do shady stuff.
What can Groundbreaker Security do for you today?
Did that mean we can just go in? The thing's off? Yes. Don't mind me, just taking a tour. I see a lot of interesting things.
Move along.
Moving along? Okay. Pardon me. What is this? A hoop? Why is there a hoop? located. Okay. Eject docking records data cartridge. Ejected. Confiscated goods. So it's a Mardet docking security terminal. Detained a freelancer who was cagey about his business. Confiscated his personal belongings while he waited for questioning. Modified pistol. Jock. Hatchet. Metal hoop. Large. Prayer beads. OSI. Locked container. Owner refused inspection. So this is the guy he's looking for, maybe? He fled before we could get down to it. Left his things behind. So they're stored in the back of the security station until the idiot shows his face again, which is likely to be never. Security logs? Sublight put a bid on one of our impounds. Generous one, too. Negotiate for the usual finder's fee and then give Lilia her salvage. Brawl at the lost hope. Freelancers versus board. Freelancers won. Arrested a freighter captain with more bits than brains. Hawthorne ship impounded by order of Udon Bedford. Still no clue why Hawthorne associates with that board sneak. A guy from the back bays roughed up the moon kid. Raving mad, warned me that the moon was going to bring about the end times. He was flying high on whatever McRed grows down there. Got a sworn testimony that McRed was spotted at the rest and go. Not that anyone will corroborate it. Reminder to keep an eye on Gladys. Leave conversation. Well, this is not a secure conversation. Sealed. Sealed. Sealed.
Okay.
Got the hoop. ID cartridge, weapon parts. Got a plasma rifle. Light ammo. Bury the hatchet. Footsteps. I walked away. What is that?
What do you think you're doing?
I was just leaving.
Just don't make more paperwork for me, alright?
Got the prayer beads. I didn't realize you were still back here. About that. Didn't want to incite paperwork. Alright, so what is up here then? Or down there? Oh. I've been over there. I've been through here, okay. Just not up here, I don't think. Have I? Oh, I have. That's why I hopped up the boxes. I wanted to land on the vending machines. What about this guy Felix? Is he still hanging out over here? Hmm. Apparently not. Well, I've been through here.
Hey, you got a second?
I was looking for you. What are you doing over here by my ship?
Fancy running into you again. Don't mind me. It's just admiring your ship from up close. Gotta hand it to you, boss. That's a fine looking ship. Only thing it's missing is me.
You're pretty eager to throw in with somebody you barely know.
Yes, I absolutely am. Just give me a shot. That's all I'm asking. I could be the best damn crew you ever hired.
Huh. Okay. All right, Felix. Tell me why I should hire you.
You're serious. You're giving me a shot. All right. Hang on. I put together a little speech, just in case you asked.
Seriously?
Hey there. I'm Felix Millstone. I have prepared a list of reasons why I believe you should hire me to join the crew of your ship and or outlaw gang.
And or outlaw gang? Are you reading this off your hand?
Yeah. It's a second draft. Firstly, I am highly personable, and I get along well with anyone who is not of the jackass persuasion.
Sorry. He's funny.
Secondly, I can be counted on in the event of a firefight, standoff, and or raid. My motto is, if you need a steady gun hand, I'm your man. That motto is it's a work in progress.
Okay, continue.
Additionally, I have several years of experience as a box hauler. This skill may come in handy if you need a body dragged away or a door held open while escaping enemy fire. In conclusion, thank you for considering me for your ship crew and or outlaw gang. I look forward to our adventures together.
I thought that was real good, Felix.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. What do you think? Am I in?
Dragging off bodies? Shootouts? What kind of shift do you think I'm running?
The fun kind? I mean, what else do you do when you got a ship of your own?
Alright, good answer. Welcome aboard.
Wow. You don't know how long I've been waiting to hear that. Thanks, boss. You're not gonna regret this.
We'll see you in the ship, Felix.
I'll just gather my personals and meet you on board. This is gonna be great.
You got a crew now, Felix.
Okay. Well. We're gathering quite a lot of people here. So next episode, yeah. That's one long session here. Next episode, we will get more acquainted with Felix. We will check out the quarters of the people that we've, I guess, not so much hired as accepted into our ranks. We need to play back the distress call message, which is also going to happen on the ship. And we need to talk to Max, give him this cartridge or whatever it is, a data card, whatever it is we have that he's been looking for. So we got a bunch of things to do on the ship, and after that, we're probably going to be going to the back bay to take care of our wanted man and find some parts for the radiators. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.